community coroner is, under the Coroner's Act, is responsible for overseeing a death investigation in the province. The Coroner's Act does provide a guideline for what coroners do in this particular province, but in short, they are responsible for guiding the investigation, for overseeing the investigation, which focuses on a number of answering a number of questions, such as who died, the medical cause of death, the manner of death, the date of death, the place of death, all of those types of information that we put on a death certificate, actually. There are two types of coroners in this province. There are full-time coroners and there are part-time coroners. Part-time coroners we call community coroners. And community coroners are located throughout the province, and we currently have about 116 scattered throughout the province.
1983, 1984, I became a community coroner. I came from the healthcare background. I was the director of nursing of the hospital out there at the time. I was used to those types of cases, but I certainly had never thought about forensics or that type of work. To be a coroner, it does take a certain skill, a certain person, a personality. I believe that if you were to ask me about cases, and I won't talk about them, but if you were to ask me about cases, I could probably relive every case that I've done.
The other really, really important thing is that they're the first person that next of kin, family members, police officers will meet at the scene of death. It's critical from our perspective that that relationship be solid right from the beginning, because in some circumstances they're going to have to be in connection or contact with family members, friends, and that sort of thing until such time as the investigation is complete.
It was when I got involved in helping the family that I became connected and committed and decided that this is something that I want to do, because it fit into the work that I did, and that was helping others. It's the urgency of the crisis that happens for the family, to be able to help them walk through those moments in time and to be able to try and find the answers. And we can't always give them the answers, but to help them understand why there's maybe no answers, or to help them work through those moments in time until you can get the answers for them.